السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر
ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولًا سديدًا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we bear witness that there is no God except Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. Ramadan is a huge blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And with this blessing, as with every blessings, it require us to analyze and to examine how well we are using this blessing. If Allah gives us eyes, we are taught and we are told to analyze and to measure how grateful we are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based on our use of these eyes. If we are given home, then we are taught to analyze how well and how grateful to Allah we are by the actions and the things that are taking place in the house. This is the way how to show gratitude and how to measure your level of iman. And so likewise, with the blessing of Ramadan, we have to ask ourselves, have I been doing good in the last few days? Have I been making the most of our days and our nights, the hours and the minutes of Ramadan? These are the questions that you yourself, only yourself, can answer for yourself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us all make the most out of these days. Allahumma ameen. Al-ghuradu min al-siyami huwa al-taqwa. وهو شأن عظيم وهي ليست مجرد كلمة وإنما هي طريقة حياة أسلوب حياة يعيش به المسلم. قال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. He said سبحانه وتعالى All you who believe, صيام, fasting has been prescribed upon you as it has been prescribed upon the people before you. So achieving taqwa, Ramadan is all about achieving taqwa. Such a word and such a term that no translation can do it justice. It's a very wide and very comprehensive term. To achieve taqwa is a purpose for every Muslim, specifically during the month of Ramadan. And if you pause and contemplate about your prayer, for example, we start reciting Surah Al-Fatiha at the beginning of every rak'ah. We say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. We ask Allah to guide us to the straight path. And then move to the next chapter, Surah Al-Baqarah, which is the longest surah that Quran starts with after Surah Al-Fatiha. The second verse, it says, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That the guidance for the pious people, the righteous people, the people who want to maintain taqwa is embedded in this book, Al-Qur'an Al-Azim. So in order for us to be able to maintain and achieve taqwa by the end of Ramadan, I would say during the month of Ramadan, so we have the opportunity to enjoy this, the taste of Iman during the month of Ramadan. It's said that there are five stages for taqwa. I would say, let's imagine that the taqwa is like a building of five floors. The first floor, the foundation is ittiqa'u shirk, to avoid disbelief. And the second floor is ittiqa'u al-ma'asi, to avoid sins. And the third floor is ittiqa'u al-shubuhat, to avoid being in the gray area. And the fourth floor is asceticism, az-zuhd, tahqiq az-zuhd fi ayyamina wa fi hayatina. Amma, as for the fifth floor, is watchfulness of Allah. And we are aiming to get to the top of this building. Along the month of Ramadan, you are going up and up. Your level is getting up. Your level of Iman is getting up and higher till you get to the top of this building. But you have to go through all of these steps and all of these stages. أولا اتقاء الشرك وهذا هو أصل الدين ألا يشرك أحد بالله شيئا. So when we say to avoid disbelief, it means that still, even though you are Muslim and you are, alhamdulillah, to have the fear not to be Muslim anymore. And to avoid anything that might cause in losing the religion. Avoid this place and avoid this whole spectrum. To have the fear. We all, the time, feel that alhamdulillah we are believers, but we still have this kind of fear that I might be Muslim, I might not be Muslim anymore. May Allah protect us all. Even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he used to say, O turner of the hearts, make my heart steadfast on the religion. يَا مُقَلِّبَ الْقُلُوبِ ثَبِّتْ قَلْبِي عَلَى دِينِكَ وَلَيْسَ أَحَدٌ كَبِيرٌ عَلَى الْفِتْنَةِ فَلْنَتَّقِي الشِّرْكِ وَنَخَافْ مِنْ أَنْ يَقَعَ الْإِنسَانُ فِي مَا يعني يعارض الإيمان والإسلام. نسأل الله تعالى العافية. This is the foundation of the building. Let's go up a little bit to the second floor. Now we are caring about more. Now alhamdulillah we feel comfortable with our religion, with our Islam. Let's try to add something else, which is the second floor in this building of achieving the top of this building, which is taqwa. The second floor is about avoiding sins. Avoid committing sins. Start questioning yourself. Am I abusing my eyes? Am I looking to something that Allah made haram? Am I eating haram? Am I purchasing something haram? Am I doing something haram? Start asking yourself in order to fix the things day by day. Now you are going in the right track and in the right path. Number three, now we are going up a little bit. If you're okay with your Islam and you're okay with the concept of al-ma'asi, and when we say al-ma'asi, the sins, we are not asked to be angels. We commit sins, but we have to make repentance right away and not to be insisting on any type of ma'asiyah and to determine not to get back and to utilize the means and to do everything possible to be away from al-ma'asi. Now you are in the safe side and you are in the very right place, but still, we have still to fix our hearts in order to reach to the top of this building, which is the building of at-taqwa. الأمر التالي أن يحاول الإنسان اتقاء الشبهات وهذا أمر مهم. To be away from the gray area. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الحلال بين والحرام بين وبينهما أمور مشتبهات فمن اتقى الشبهات فقد استبرأ لدينه وعرضه. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم that which is lawful, which is halal is clear. Which is haram is clear for everyone. But still, this is an area, and a gray area between it, that at some point, you cannot decide whether it is halal or haram. I would say to myself, as long as I don't know it is halal or haram, I just avoid it for the sake of Allah. I just avoid it. I cannot do a thing that might cause to the displeasure of my Lord. Just be aware of it. If your money is engaged into any transaction that you feel worry about it in terms of usury and this stuff, just avoid it for the sake of Allah. And don't try to find excuses, because all of us are able to list a huge excuses for ourselves. But who knows? Maybe on the Day of Judgment, all of these excuses not going to help. So avoiding the gray area, the area that's between halal and haram. So long as you're not certain, just be away from it. Just to protect yourself, to protect your religion, and to be away from the things that bring the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now we are going up a little bit. The fourth floor is to start exercising zuhd, asceticism. والزهد يا أحباب هو ترك شيء من المباح. يعني ربما يكون هذا الأمر مباحا لكنك تتركه لأنه قد يترتب عليه مفسدة. When we say the word asceticism, we mean that maybe you are enjoying your time home, you are playing games, you are watching an episode or so, which is okay, it's allowed under some conditions. It's not our point now, but let's say everyone knows which is halal and which is haram. But let's say that it's like 15 minutes left till Salah, for example. I cannot say I'm going just to finish this game. I'm going just to end this episode and then I go make wudu and run to the masjid. We cannot say this. Rather just slide everything on the table, rush, make wudu, get into your car and drive to the masjid. Why? Because you know that this is the best act that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. So it's not about halal and haram in this point. Maybe you are just sitting, you know, you are sitting around your family members, exchanging talks and spending nice time. Still, at that point, when is the time for salah, just leave, which is mubah, to rush to which is mandatory salat al-jama'ah, and so, salat al-fariidah. This is a level of iman, and this is a path of taqwa, that if we start working on it during the month of Ramadan, our characters and our life will be, inshallah, changed to the best. And now we are getting to the top of this building, which is the watchfulness, al-muraqabah. To be watchful of every word and everything you do. Always Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in front of your eyes. Allah comes first in your life. Before doing something, before taking a step, before, you know, spending money, before earning money, before going somewhere, before engaging into a talk, before joining a group of people, always think, is it pleased to Allah or the other way? Am I on the right path? Does this act please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or not? Otherwise, I would quit it. I would leave it for the sake of Allah. So in this way, when you take these steps, take it gradually, take it step by step. Don't exhaust yourself. And the rest of Ramadan, alhamdulillah, we still have like 25 days. You have the ability, inshaAllah, by the help of Allah, by always saying, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, to achieve the top of this building and to be amongst al-muttaqeen. نسأل الله تعالى أن يجعلنا وإياكم من عباده المتقين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد رسول الله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه واجمعنا يا رب به في مستقر رحمتك ودار كرامتك يا رب العالمين. قلنا يا أحباب إن الهدف من هذا الشهر الفضيل أن يحقق الإنسان التقوى والتي هي مناط العبادة وقد تصدر بها القرآن الكريم بعد سورة الفاتحة في قول الله تعالى ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين والتقوى إنما هي على خمس مراحل لمن أراد ولمن ابتغى أن يحققها نسأل الله أن يمن علينا جميعا. أولا اتقاء الشرك ثانيا اتقاء المعاصي ثالثا اتقاء الشبهات رابعا أخذ شيء من الزهد في هذه الحياة وهذا باب واسع خامساً المراقبة أن يكون الإنسان مراقباً دائماً بأقواله وأفعاله وأن يعلم أن الله تعالى مطلع عليه. So in these few minutes we tried to emphasize the importance of maintaining taqwa and the way how to make it because this is a goal that we all should be aware of how to achieve it. And we mentioned that we give an example, it's like a building of 5 floors. The foundation is to avoid anything and to be away from anything that, you know, related to disbelief, shirk. And the second floor is to avoid committing sins to the best of your abilities. And the third floor is to avoid the gray area, which is between halal and haram, a thing that you're not aware of. And the fourth floor is to have kind of asceticism and zuhd in this dunya, and the top of this building is to be watchful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything you do and in everything you say. This is actually what I wanted to deliver for today, and before ending here, I just wanted to let you know that we today have an organization, some of our brothers, they are standing downstairs, they call UMR, United Mission of Relief and Development. They are doing several projects and they are actually providing humanitarian aid for our brothers and fellow Muslims in Gaza, in Gaza. And for right now, they are in need for food baskets, as I've been told. So please stop by, take a look, and try to support. This is also one of the things that elevate your rank in this dunya and help you maintain taqwa by standing in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نسأل الله تعالى أن يمن علينا وعليكم بالرضا وأن يمن علينا وعليكم بالقبول. اللهم تقبلنا وقبل منا. اللهم تقبلنا وقبل منا. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا وتوفنا وأنت راض عنا. اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله. اجعل يا رب هذا الشهر الفضيل باب فتح ونصر وعزة وكرامة للمسلمين. اللهم إنك على كل شيء قدير. أغثنا يا مغيث، أغثنا يا مغيث، أغثنا يا مغيث. انصر يا رب إخواننا المرابطين في غزة في فلسطين. وانصر يا رب دينك وارفع كلمتك وكتابك وسنة نبيك في كل قطر من أقطار هذه الأرض يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنا نستعين بك فأعنا. اللهم إنا نستعين بك فأعنا. اللهم إنا نستعين بك فأعنا. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك. فإن مع العسر يسرا. إن مع العسر يسرا. فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله يا الله لمن حمده. الله 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 أكبر. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
آمين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله. سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.